What is going on, guys? My name is Prestige. Welcome to episode number 6 of a little series that I like to call Epic Weapons of Infinite Warfare. In this series, we take a look at the epic weapons that make up Infinite Warfare. I let you know whether or not those weapons are worth the 4,000 salvage or just completely forgetting in the armory. If you happen to miss any of the other previous episodes, you can find a complete playlist linked down below in the description and in the form of an annotation at the end of this video. Without further ado, let's get into today's episode. Before we do, I want to say happy Thanksgiving to everybody out there that does celebrate it. Eat up and get fat like I am, and hopefully you guys like it. But anyway, today we're going to be talking about the Kendall 44. This is the Cartel. The only way to get this weapon is by reaching level 40 mission team with the Wraith mission team. This is the final team in the list, and once you do, you'll be given this weapon. Now, there are a couple different benefits to it. We have the hit and run. This is going to provide a normal movement speed while aiming down sight, which does come in handy in certain circumstances. But if we're going to be real with each other, all this is doing is adding a free stock to your weapon. Normally, you're able to choose the stock attachment to allow you to strafe easier while aiming down sight, and that allows your movement speed, obviously, to increase while you're aiming down sight. But you can't for the Cartel. It's literally just a stock, and that is that. Where this weapon really shines comes in the second perk, and that would be Steady. It's going to tighten up that hip fire spread, and the fact that you could stack the laser sight on top of this makes it a complete hip fire beast, which you can clearly see in this gameplay. One more thing that I need to make mention of, the Kendall 44 has the best hip fire accuracy out of all of the pistols in its category, which is absolutely fantastic already, so do yourselves a favor and forget about the hit and run. Having a single pistol and being able to have the stock attachment free is pretty cool, but if you want to have even more fun with this particular variant, throw on these three attachments. We have akimbo, we have laser sight, and of course we have the auto sear to flip that fun switch and make this weapon completely automatic. As for the perks, I would recommend gung-ho firstly, because that allows you to spray and pray while you're sprinting, and since you have that increased hipfire spread, it's really not going to get that much bigger while you're running. So if there is somebody in front of you or at a longer distance that you don't necessarily think that you're able to hit, I would just say run the course of your magazine with both of your weapons, spray and pray, hipfire your way to victory, and hopefully you take them out. And since you're going to be consuming a lot of ammunition, I would recommend putting on the scavenger perk as well. In this particular gameplay, I didn't have it unlocked yet, so I was just jumping off the map to get more ammunition so I can run and kill as many enemies as I could, but it's definitely going to come in handy, especially if you're going to be spraying like I am in this gameplay here. Now, one more thing that I would recommend is under FTL, the rig, you're able to select a trait called Power Slide. Power Slide will allow you to slide longer. This also allows you to aim down sights while sliding, but the reason I'm recommending this is because if you're going to be super active running all around the map, sliding, jumping, and things of that nature, if you're power sliding or crouching in general, your hipfire accuracy is going to be so much better while performing a slide. So the longer that you're sliding, the better your hipfire accuracy is going to be, especially with this particular setup. The final perk that I would recommend would absolutely be Dexterity, to allow you to reload faster in order to take out more enemies that may be crossing your path. Now that we know the weapon kicks some major ass in the multiplayer, how does it fare against the undead horde and zombies in Spaceland? And not so good. This is actually the starting room pistol. This is the pistol you start with, you spawn with this thing, and it's not gonna be any better or any worse than the base version. It's just going to be even more meh. The only perfect way to get this weapon doing any sort of damage is by pack-a-punching it, and unfortunately with this particular variant, if you have it dual-wield and you pack-a-punch it, you don't get two, you only get one, which kind of sucks. But the cool thing about this is, it does continue to have the same look with the same design, just upgraded in the pack-a-punch. And this is the first time that I've noticed this with any of the variants out there. So I think that this is really cool, but at the same time, it's really not any better than the regular. So you're not going to be killing zombies any faster with this thing. But at the end of the day, after testing it in zombies as well as multiplayer, is it something that you should take the time to grind out level 40 Wraith mission team? And I want to say yes, especially if you're somebody who plays the multiplayer. This is the only Kendall 44 variant that's going to give you that increased hipfire spread. It's going to be great for the akimbo as well as full auto sear attachment. It's going to be very, very fun if you're somebody who just likes to have those little fun, quirky classes and you don't really want to try too hard. It's a lot of fun in hardcore modes as well, especially if you're going to be using it singular. Having that on the go, and it's kind of like a free stock like we talked about before, is definitely going to make a big difference. Being able to to strafe around corners and take out enemies before they even know you're coming is a really big benefit for this weapon. But overall, when it comes down to it, this weapon does get my seal of approval. I definitely think it's worth the 40 levels to get. It's a free epic weapon as long as you put the time and effort in, and I think that it does look cool. The look of it is unique, and that's something that I can admire as well. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode here today. If you did, make sure to click the like button down below. Don't forget to click on the annotation right there to check out previous episodes if you want to check out any of the other epic weapons I've covered so far. And of course, guys, if you are subscribed to the channel, it would be greatly appreciated if you clicked on that notification button to be updated on when I upload my videos. Until tomorrow, guys, I will see ya. Peace.